Hello, it is me, Michal Rostov. This is Rostov Review. And it has been like a year since I done one of these, like a whole year. And you're probably like going, did he die? Because we not heard about him for like a year and a half. And no, here is a story. Okay, so hold on. So I'm getting ready, I'm recording a Rostov Review like a year ago. I hear get a knock on my door, and I'm going, oh crap, nobody knocked on my door unless two things. One of my yaks got in their house and ate their food again, or I'm gonna get killed. Okay, that's it. That's just my community, I'm used to it, it's fine. So I hear a knock on door, I have my gun ready. I open the door, boom. This guy's like, are you Michal Rostov? Yes. I am. And he goes, come with me, please. Okay, I get in, I follow him. I get in his car, black car, no license plates, nothing. And this is a nice car, which is very unusual for my area, let alone a car in general. I don't see cars, but this one, like, has all the tires and all the lights and the glass is not shattered. So I'm like, oh, this is weird. This is weird. So I get in his car. And we drive for like 45 minutes, okay? Like a long time. And I'm like, oh crap. The guy does not say a word to me the whole time. And I'm just waiting and waiting to get shot. And we get to this building. Big building, no windows. And this is getting weirder and weirder. We go inside and he says, you have been selected to work with us. We are KGB. And you're going to be a KGB agent. And I'm going, last time I checked, this is not the Cold War. I thought KGB was like gone. And he's like, no, we're still active, but like in secret, like down below. We work in secret. So I'm like, do I have an option? And he's like, no. So I work with KGB for a year, a whole year doing KGB stuff, which a lot of it didn't make any sense. There was a lot of espionage and like killing. I kill a man. I didn't even know if I was like a good guy or a bad guy. Am I killing a good guy? I don't know. I kill a bad guy? Who knows? They said, kill this man or we kill you. And I'm like, okay, I'll kill a man so I don't get, you know, killed. So I do it. The whole year goes by. They tell me, you know, don't say anything. I'm sworn to secrecy. Keep my mouth shut. And I just told everyone online. That's probably goes against my non-disclosure agreement, but whatever, that's what happened. You need no truth. We'll KGB for a year, but I'm gone. I'm back at my house. I'm doing a film. I thought I'd do a review, you know, shit. You guys like it, supposedly, allegedly. You guys like it, so I do another one. I don't know what I'm gonna play though. I have a crap ton of games here. I have 245 games, okay? That's a lot. That's a lot of money that I just threw away. Okay? And I have no freaking idea what I'm going to play. I have to build up my fan base again after a whole year of freaking nothing. No, you guys, I don't know if you guys like moved on to another Russian who does it. Not that I don't know any other Russians who do. There's a guy who does like Russian science experiments. That's kind of cool. Until he burned his house down, but you know. Build another house, big deal. Don't play with chemicals. Now I remember back when I first started, I was like, hello, Michal Rostov. I want a bunch of subscribers and make lots of money. That guy was a dickhead, okay? Let's be realistic here. So if I keep the same amount of subscribers as before, I'll be a happy camper. What does that expression mean, a happy camper? What's a sad camper? Like if your foot get caught in a bear trap, you're probably not happy, right? Cause your foot is shattered and you're in the middle of the woods. I guess a happy camper is someone who has like beef jerky for dinner. I don't know. I think people just say things and then other people continue to say them and it just spirals out of control until it's something everyone says till the end of time. Ugh, God. I just had like a full glass of yak's milk. Always makes me gassy. I get like acid reflux. But it's free, because I have 1,000 yaks. So, do I want to spend $40 on a gallon of milk? No, I have yaks milk. Even though it's kind of, you have to like chew it, it's kind of crunchy. Because my yaks are gross. Has anyone ever seen a yak? Hold on. I feel like I talk about yaks enough that you guys should see what the picture of a yak is. This is a yak, okay? I have hundreds of them. They're just like bison, but stupider. They're just so, they're so stupid. They wander in the traffic, they fall in holes. They dig holes, and then other yaks fall in the holes that the ones dug. Pull these on so I can hear things. Uh-oh. Oh! It's uncomfortable! Here's our vehicle. Starts right up. Yes! We're moving on the world's worst road. These some crappy roads, man. You know, this is not unlike my roads. Except more snow. Oh my god. I'm not like a master of infrastructure, but I believe roads are supposed to be above the water. God, this is some nasty mud. This game is really pretty though. I mean, look at that. Look at these graphics. Nothing like HD mud. There's trees in the road. Oh crap, what the hell? Oh my, what the hell just, oh, shit. I'm gonna have to get this user's truck to get the other one out. Crap. That made no sense, that tree took control. The tree pulled us in the headlock and just slammed us on the ground. That was intense. Look at this, this truck don't give a crap about the trees. Just take control. Yes. I have no idea where we are. Wait, where's the map? Okay, so we gotta follow this road, okay. That's good. We can do that. Oh, there. Okay, there we are. Here we are. All right. So I have a winch on this truck. So I'm gonna go around here. I'm gonna back it up. All right. Faster off road. Let's go this way through the trees. Screw the roads, man. The roads are crap. Roads are crap. Shit. So. That was my first Rust Up review for a long time, like a year, like I said. I'm a year older since I've done a Rust Up review. Let me know what you want to see. I have, hold on, it's down here. I do have one of these. So if you don't know what that is that is virtual reality headset for your face. I have one of those, so I'm gonna do, let me know which virtual reality games you want me to play. And this was a short one. This is me getting back into things, getting going. So, and the games you want me to see, I'll do them, I don't care. I got a lot of time on my hands. So I hope everyone's doing good out there. And oh, I hear something. Hope everyone's doing good. I'm Mikhail Rostov. This is Rostov Review signing off for today. Everyone have a good freaking day. Okay? Good day. I'll see you all soon. Rostov Review, blurry face, signing out. Bye-bye.